This is In His Dreams, an Eve Hope FBI suspense thriller, Book 7, written by Kate Bold, read by Theresa. Prologue. "Come on, Tommy, it's just another mile from here," called Harry Falcone over his shoulder, pumping the pedals of his bicycle in regular rhythm. "Another mile?" 11-year-old Tommy Falcone complained. "You said this bike ride would be quick and easy." "Sure," his older brother laughed. "We ride quick now so we can take it easy afterward. Come on, the guys are waiting for us down by the old bridge." "We're not even supposed to be here," Tommy whined from behind as the boys pedaled down the trail, through the trees, over the gulches and streams. The sign said no trespassing. "They just put those up to scare you," Harry yelled back. "They never check. I don't think anybody uses these trails anymore." The boys rode on, passing large, silent hydro pumps and open pipelines that gaped like yawning mouths. The underbrush and foliage were overgrown and wily.
"Hey, watch out for those blackberry bushes," Harry called out. "The thorns are no joke."
Almost as the words left Harry's mouth, Tommy's tires rolled over a thick braid of thorny vines that lay half hidden in the underbrush along the narrow bike trail. There was a bang, an angry hiss as the air rushed out of the rubber tube, and Tommy was thrown flailing right over the handlebars. He landed with a leafy crunch in the dense thicket. There was blood chilling the sound of snapping bone. Tommy lay frozen in the thicket, staring up at the baby blue sky dotted with fluffy cotton ball clouds, too stunned and terrified to move. He'd heard the snap, so he knew that he must have broken something, but he couldn't feel anything. Anything at all. His whole body tingled as if his legs had fallen asleep and taken the rest of him along for good measure. There was a high-pitched whine in his ears. From up the trail, Tommy could hear his brother's tires skidding to a stop. Harry was calling back to him, but to Tommy, the words sounded like nonsense, whispered through a pair of cans on a string. His head swam.
"Tommy, are you okay back there?"
"Shit!"
Tommy saw the shape of his brother loom into his visual sphere, looking down with a pale, concerned expression on his acne-pocked face.
"What happened?" Harry asked, wading through the thicket, heedless of the thorns, towards his little brother.
"Tommy, can you stand up? You're scaring me."
"I think," Tommy said, dazed from the fall and still trying to catch the wind that had been knocked out of his chest. "I might have broken something. I can't feel it, though."
Harry studied his brother for a moment, looking at the scratch marks that the thorns had made on his arms, legs, and face. Tommy wasn't crying, but he was breathing. That was good. Tommy was a tough kid. His helmet sat slightly askew on his head, leaves sticking out of it in all directions. But Tommy's limbs seemed to be in the right places and at the proper angles, and Harry didn't see any bone jutting out from anywhere. He squatted down, getting his arms underneath his brother's shoulders.
"All right, little man, up we go," Harry grunted, hoisting his younger sibling up by the armpits and throwing Tommy's little elbow over his own shoulders.
The boys hobbled out of the dense blackberry bramble. Tommy appeared to be walking just fine, and the scrapes and scratches seemed shallow and ultimately harmless. Harry sighed, giving his brother an appraising look, then glancing back down the trail. The bridge was waiting, and Jack Respoon, de facto leader of the neighborhood gang, had acquired a whole backpack of illegal Chinese fireworks. It was going to be an awesome day of explosions, fire, and danger. Or it would have been. Harry's heart sank as he stared at Tommy's flattened tire. There was no way he would be able to convince his brother, who was already tired of the bike ride, to continue walking his bike to the bridge. It was going to be a long enough walk home as it was, and Tommy still seemed to be in a state of suspended shock.
"I don't think you broke anything," Harry said to Tommy.
Tommy shook his head, still staring at the blackberry thicket.
"I heard it, Harry. I know I did."
"All right, so you heard something snap. Maybe it was a twig or something. Here, let me feel your arms and legs, all right? You tell me if and where it hurts." Tommy consented to let his brother assess his limbs, although he wore a lemon-sour face.
Harry's hands palpated his little brother's arms from wrist to shoulder, then checked his knees and shins. Nothing felt wrong or out of place, although the 14-year-old boy was certainly no orthopedic authority, and Tommy didn't wince.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.